Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to discuss about the contact stresses. Evaluation of contact stresses is routinely required in machine components such as gear teeth, ball bearings, and wheels on rail, and many more applications. In this module, we will discuss about the nature of contact stresses for two useful cases. One, contact between two spheres, and two, contact between two cylinders. We will learn about how to calculate the contact stresses near the contact zone based on the theory which was developed by Hertz. Finally, we will solve an illustrative numerical problem based on the contact stresses. Let's begin with some of the situations which need evaluation of contact stresses. The first example you see on the screen is that of two gears transmitting the power. The gear teeth are constantly subjected to contact stresses. Similarly, in the case of bearings, the rolling elements, that is the spherical balls or the cylindrical rolling elements in the bearing, are subjected to contact stresses. In cam and followers, the touching surfaces are subjected to contact stresses. The basic fundamental work in the contact stresses was done by Heinrich Hertz, who was a German physicist and is well known for his work in electromagnetic waves. He developed his theory based on experiments of a glass sphere contacting on a lens. Let's have some understanding about the nature of contact stresses. When two bodies are touching each other, as shown in the left hand side figure, in case of two spheres contacting, there is a point contact, and in case of two cylinders contacting, there is a line contact. As the load increases, because these two bodies are deformable, as shown in the right hand side figure, the deformable body deforms and takes a shape so as to increase the area of contact. As a result of this, some finite amount of stresses get developed at this particular region. The first step in calculating the contact stresses is to estimate the size of this region which is caused by the deformation due to the load. In this module, we are not going into the theoretical derivation of the equations involved. Rather, they are directly given here in this particular slide. The first case we are considering is that of two spheres which are in contact with each other. The diameters of the spheres are given as small d1 and small d2, and the load acting on them is given as capital F. Under the action of this load F, a contact region gets developed, in this case of circular size, and that radius of this contact zone is given as small a. The coordinate axes are defined such that along the depth of the spheres you are defining as a z axis, and the remaining two axes, in this case the horizontal plane axis, are x and y plane. The nature of distribution of stresses along the contact zone is of elliptical type, with the maximum stress occurring at the center of the contact zone. The stresses are given in terms of the size of contact zone. The dimension A is given in terms of the load F and the material properties and geometric properties of the bodies. So in this case, nu1 and nu2 are Poisson's ratio of the two materials, e1 and e2 are moduli of elasticity of the two materials, and d1 and d2 are the diameters of the two spheres. Once we have calculated the value of A, the maximum contact pressure which occurs at the center of contact region is given by means of the formula as shown on the screen. The stresses in x, y, and z direction are given by the expressions which are given on the screen. Note that at any point at a distance z from the contact surface, that means you are measuring z starting from the contact region. So at any depth z from starting from the contact surface, you will get the value of sigma x, sigma y and sigma z as shown here. Note that in the region directly below the center of contact region, the shear stresses are zero. And hence, this sigma x, sigma y and sigma z at any point are the principal stresses. Let's look more closely into the nature of stresses which occur in the case of two spheres. Let's first consider the difference which will occur because of the material, that is, we'll consider a ductile material versus brittle material. The ductile material will have a smaller modulus of elasticity, so we'll get E values which are smaller, as a result of which the numerator will be larger and hence A also will be larger. And as can be seen from the second formula, if A is larger, you will get the P max or the related contact stresses, they will be smaller. Thus, the ductile materials will have less contact stress as compared to two brittle materials contacting each other. So if you consider two hard materials pressing against each other and two softer materials against the same amount of contact load, the contact stress in the case of softer material or ductile material will be smaller. Similarly, let's consider the effect of diameter of the spheres. Let's consider the diameter to be small, so both D1 and D2 to be small. If they are smaller in size, we'll have the denominator would be large, and as a result of this, A will be smaller. And because A is smaller, looking at the equation for P max, the P max will be larger. That means the stresses, the contact stresses between two small spheres will be larger as compared to the stresses between two large spheres. We'll also have a look at another factor which is required in this analysis. Many times you are having the spheres coming in contact with flat plates or spheres which are placed inside another sphere. Let's first consider a spherical body which is placed on a flat surface. So in this case, obviously the upper body will have diameter D1. For the flat surface, we consider the diameter D2 as equal to infinity, because it's flat surface, it is considered to have a very large radius sphere. And then you can solve this problem by considering 1 by D2 equal to 0. Now consider the case where we are having the sphere which is kept inside another sphere. So again, in this case, D1 will be as the diameter of the sphere, whereas the outer spherical surface which is having diameter D2, in the formula you will be considering D2 with negative sign. So with this modification, you can apply this formulae for different geometries, such as the sphere placed on flat plate or sphere placed inside another spherical surface, and such problems can be handled. The figure on the screen shows the variation of stresses starting from the contact surface and moving towards the center of spheres. The y-axis represents the distance from the contact surface given in terms of the ratio z divided by a. The x-axis represents the ratio of stress to that of Pmax value. The variation of stress sigma z, as can be seen here, it starts maximum value on the surface and it decreases gradually as you move towards the center. Similarly, the values of sigma x and sigma y, which are equal, they also start maximum at the contact surface and decrease as you move towards the inside of sphere. This is a three-dimensional case in which the sigma x, sigma y and sigma z, they represent the principal stresses. The maximum shear stress for 3D state is defined as maximum of the absolute value of sigma x minus sigma y by 2, sigma y minus sigma z by 2, and sigma z minus sigma x by 2. We have to take the mod sign for all the expressions. If you plot the variation of maximum shear stress on the same graph, you will find that the value initially increases as you go inside. It peaks at a certain depth below the surface, and afterwards it gradually decreases. We are interested in this maximum value and where it occurs. It can be shown that the maximum value occurs at a depth equal to z by a equal to 0.5, and the magnitude of maximum shear stress is given as 0.31 times Pmax. Let's now consider two cylinders which are in touch with each other. In this case, similar to that of the case of spheres, we are having the half width of contact region, which is termed here as small b, is an important parameter. Along with that, the length of cylinder, that is L, is also required for the calculations. The formulae are given as shown on the screen. We have to note here that with respect to the formula for the spherical contact, where you are having the contact width in terms of cube root, whereas in this case we are having the formula in terms of square root. Just note this so that you don't make mistake there. The maximum contact pressure is given in terms of load and the size of contact region. Once you have obtained the value of Pmax, the sigma x, sigma y and sigma z at any point which is directly below the center of the cylinders are given by the values of sigma, by the expressions which are given here in terms of the z, where z is measured from the contact point. So z is measured starting from the contact surface. The nature of stresses within the cylinders is as shown in the next slide. So here again you will find that both sigma x, sigma y as well as sigma z, they decrease as you move towards the center. However, the maximum shear stress, it increases and it peaks at a certain depth below the contact surface. This depth in this case can be shown to be equal to z divided by b equal to 0.78, and the maximum shear stress is given as 0.301 times Pmax. You can mathematically derive these values, but for the sake of calculations, you can simply use these expressions as they are.